Good morning. Welcome to St. Patrick's Parish. We have the following announcements. Our Thanksgiving ecumenical service is held here at St. Patrick's this year, this Monday, November 20th at 7 p.m. in the church. Join us. Our annual Thanksgiving Day Mass with blessing of any food items not already in the oven will take place this Thursday morning at 8 a.m. Join us. Advent confessions begin Monday, November 27th from 6 to 7 p.m. in the church. Finally, the Feast of the Immaculate Conception of Mary, a holy day of obligation, will be on Friday, December 8th. Masses will take place at 8 a.m. and 7 p.m. that day. Let us begin our prayer by singing hymn number 599, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light, number 599.
Everyone.
Morning, Father.
We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we join together this morning, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the day star. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of Justice. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you reign with the Father in the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Have mercy on us.
us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you, for you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief at night. When people are saying peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of the darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately, the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing the additional 5. He said, Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy. Then the one who had received 2 talents also came forward and said, Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy. Then the one who had received the 1 talent came forward and said, Master, I knew you were a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant and gathering where you did not scatter. So out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back. His master said to him in reply, You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter? Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. This is the gospel of the Lord.
You know, the word gospel means good news, but it would seem that for one of the servants, the news was not so good. Did you catch that? Are you awake? Okay, stay with me, my friends, because this is gonna be the whole lead in, and if we don't get this, you're gonna be looking at me going, what are you talking about, Father? Because when we hear in the gospel, they're all given these talents, which is an extremely large sum of money in the ancient world, to go out and trade according to their abilities. We see in that moment the master entrusting them to just say, go out and do the best you can and do something with this. But what happens? 2 of them go out and do just that. And each of them bear fruit. They come back with double what they had, which is a great thing. The other, though, you kind of look at it and go, what happened here? Because you get the line from the master, you wicked, lazy servant. And it's like, ooh, what happened? That's not exactly what we would call the opening we want to hear from the master. But he says, you knew all these things, and still you chose to do nothing. I gave you this responsibility and these gifts to be able to go and bear fruit, and you chose to just bury it in a field and just hand it back to me with nothing. So he goes, okay, this isn't going to fly. And so it is, dear friends, with all of us. Because where we haven't been given a, quote, large sum of money, we have been given the gift of our own lives. And our own lives are meant to bear fruit, as Christ says in the scriptures, and fruit that will last. Not by our power just manifesting it in our own strength, but by God himself working in and through us to bring about these goods in the midst of our world. We don't have to do this all on our own. But what we don't have an option of is not to play. Is to just sit back and say, well, it's somebody else's problem, it's somebody else's issue. I'm going to take myself and remove myself from the equation. And then at the end of our life, we just go, here it is, Lord, I'm just giving it back to you. And you go, wait a minute, what's going on here? Because each of us, each person in this room, every person in the world, is made in the image and likeness of God. And yet we also have this thing called free will. You know a little about free will? You exercised free will? You came to Mass this morning, you exercised good free will? There we go. It's a wonderful thing, but we are the only creatures in humanity that can actually rebel against what we're called to. Because God has given us the ability to choose things that are not of him. And basically, we kind of see this servant look at everything and go, all right, I'm not going to play. I'm not even going to engage. I'm just going to bury this in a field, and then I'll hand it back to him at the end. That's not what we're called to, dear friends. Because God has given us the ability to bear a lot of fruit in this life, because each of you have a different kind of talent. A different set of particular gifts. Maybe what we would say in our own modern world, a particular set of skills. And you have been given the ability for those to be strengthened by an encounter with God himself that comes through a multitude of things. First and foremost, an encounter with him that is meant to happen every time we walk into church. Because that encounter comes from the Lord himself, who wants to engage in what? Communion with us. He knows we're weak. He knows we're able to falter. But because of that, he's given us ways to be forgiven, and he's given us ways to enter into deep communion with him so that we can make our way forward in this world. He knows it's hard. But that's why he said from the beginning there, I'm not going to leave you or forsake you. I'm not going to abandon you. Indeed, he sends us this gift of the Holy Spirit that is given to us at baptism and confirmation, strengthened in confirmation, to go out and live this gospel message in a world that's not exactly on our team all the time. Because we go back to free will, and how many do we know who are taking their free will and saying, yeah, I'm going to go a different direction. This is why it's important for us to play the role in the body of Christ that we've been designed for. Because the Lord loves us so much and he wants us to be a part of this entire thing. We're made for purpose and the Lord has given us that purpose. And yet so often we toss it to the side and say, I'm going to do it my own way. Prayer is something, dear friends, that will take us into the depths that we're made for. Yes, we have the creed that we pray every Sunday, and the catechism expounds upon all the meaning behind that. Yes, we have the gift of the sacraments, and that gift that is meant to infuse the love of God into our hearts such that we can live out this calling that we couldn't otherwise do on our own strength. And yes, we have those guideposts that is this life in Christ, the moral life, to help us to stay in the balance so that everything we receive in those sacraments is powerful and efficacious. But if we don't have prayer, then all of this remains up here in the head as a kind of a knowledge base, as opposed to drifting the 18 inches it needs to down to here, the heart. Because without that, dear friends, if it's not a part of us, it'll become meaningless. And we can drift into some very interesting places. Because at the end of the day, God wants us home, but that very free will that he's given us, if we don't exercise it properly, we can end up in a very precarious spot. Case in point, anybody ever been on a cruise? Okay, a few of you. Anybody ever been to like Bermuda or something, right? Okay, great. Here's the thing. It's a pretty small island, is it not? This is where you shake your head, yes, Father? Okay, there we go. Yeah, stay with me. We're almost there. Let's say I set the compass wrong by a single degree. Is it going to make a big deal up here in like Boston? Is it going to get me into trouble when I'm trying to aim for Bermuda? Big time. I'm either going to hit the island or I'm going to end up in the middle of the Atlantic and we're in trouble. You're going to be looking for land and there ain't going to be any land to be found. This is the thing. Our Christian life is much the same way. God is always holding out to us this gift of eternal life and calling us to it, but he is never going to force our hand. But he is saying to us, it's like, if you're going to do this, I'm going to show you all the love I can, and I'm going to make sure you know it by a sacrifice on that cross, but also I need you to love me back by the same gift of making a sacrifice in our own life to live out this calling. And believe me when I tell you, dear friends, God's not outdone in generosity. If we're generous with him, he'll be even more generous with us, even in the trials that we'll face in this life. Because he will draw us into the mystery of the fullness of his love. So with all that in mind, dear friends, the question we face this morning is, are we going to take the gifts, the talents, if you will, that God has poured into our hearts and use them as he's designed? Because he knows exactly who you and I are. He has built us from the ground up, and from the first moment we entered into time and space, he knew exactly who we were made to be and the pathway that would fill our hearts most in this life. If we choose to live that, then I assure you, you don't have to worry about talents bearing fruit and doubling the amount. It'll happen just by you living out the call that God has put into your heart. But if we decide to go another way, if we decide to be like the servant who says, I'm not going to play, I'm going to do my own thing, I'm kind of just going to say, good luck, Lord, and here's the talent back, then we can't be surprised then if the Lord says, if you don't want me for all eternity, that's fine. I'll give you what you desire most. One more compass analogy, dear friends. You ever seen that crazy movie, Pirates of the Caribbean? I know, curious way to end a homily, but so be it, right? Do you remember Jack Sparrow's compass? What's it point to? Oh, don't all answer this one at once. What does it point to? What you want most. What you want most. For all of us, let's make sure that compass is pointing towards eternal life and the gift that we can only receive from God himself, which is the gift of an eternal love beyond all telling. Let us stand now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Placing our hearts and minds before the Lord, let us offer all of our prayers before him this day as we open our hearts to him in all things.
For believers who suffer persecution, and for non-believers seeking the truth, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For a world filled with peace and security, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For civilians caught in the midst of war, and for family members trying to keep peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the belief that we ask for in faithful prayer, we will receive from our loving God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our mission parish in Haiti, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. That those who are sick or near death and those who care for them know the reality of God's love through the community's support of them. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those friends and loved ones who've gone before us into the embrace of our Lord's arms, whom we'll remember in this liturgy, and especially this morning for Mark Kerrigan, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. And for all those who are suffering under conflict in their homeland, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all the intentions of our parish prayer chain, and for all those prayers that each and every one of us holds deep in our own hearts that are known only to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, strengthen our hearts on this journey of faith to trust in the pathway laid out by you, that we may draw closer to Jesus Christ in the midst of our life, being led by the Holy Spirit, may serve you as you desire, and enter one day into your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our gifts are brought to the altar, let us join together in singing hymn number 652, River of Glory, number 652.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he's unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we acclaim. Rightly gives you praise, but through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death.
Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God. With blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Patrick, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, and Robert our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us now offer each other a sign of peace.
Sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Now for the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth and charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, I thank all who came out last night to the Turkey Social. It was a very fun evening, if not a little bit of a tiring evening for everybody involved, but thank you so much. And for all those who volunteered or helped in any way, shape, or form, very, very grateful. It was a wonderful evening. Albeit, I think I need to sleep for about 7 years now after everything, and I'm sure there's others who need to do the same. So, but thank you all for coming out last night. It was a wonderful evening. Saint Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl around the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our celebration is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Have a great week, everyone.
You too, Father.
As we go forth together, let us sing hymn number 582, Soon and Very Soon, number 582.